Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to talk about graphing with calculus and calculators. So we have a function here, and the directions say to sketch f of x equals x over x squared plus x plus 3. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you some techniques you can use in your graphing calculator to help you sketch this. Okay, I'm going to show you how to find all of the important information using a calculator. So calculator's on. I'm going to access the menu to enter functions, and we're looking at x divided by parentheses x squared plus x plus 3. This is an older calculator. A lot of newer calculators, it looks a little bit better when you type it in. I'm going to hit graph. And you can see that it doesn't look very good. So our first task is going to be to make it look better. So basically, it's because the window is off. So the maximum value here by default in most calculators for y is 10, and the minimum is negative 10. This is called y max 10. This is called y min negative 10. And the minimum value is usually negative 10 for x, and the maximum is 10 for x. So you can manually adjust it in the window. Let's go ahead and manually adjust it. So let's go to window. And it looks like we need to come down on the y's. So maybe let's try y min of negative 2, and then y max of 2. And let's hit graph and let's see how that looks. So it certainly looks better, but I don't think it's great. And you notice there's a tick mark here. I don't know if you can see that. There's a little tick mark. That's tick mark of 1. So let's bring it down even more. Let's make that y max 1. I'm going to go back to the window. And let's just change it to y min negative 1, and then y max 1. And let's see if that helps. That's pretty good, right? That's pretty good. So already we see some key knowledge. It looks like the concavity changes at 0 because it's concave up, concave up, concave up, concave up, and then all of a sudden it's concave down. So this function will be concave up from negative infinity to 0, and then concave down from 0 to infinity. So we've got the concavity, we've got an inflection point. That's the point where the concavity changes. That would be 0, 0. We've also got maxes and mins that we can actually find. If you hit trace, you can approximate them. Most calculators have a trace feature. So roughly 0.22 or around there, 0.22. That's a very rough maximum. And then down here, roughly negative 1.7 maybe. So we can do better than rough though. We can. We can actually find the maximum and minimum. So there's a blue key here on this particular calculator. It's called calc. And so to access the blue key, I have to press second first. So watch this. Second, calc, and let's find the minimum. So you go to here where it says minimum. You press enter. And then it says left bound. So what that means is it wants an x value that's to the left of my minimum, which I already have. And I press enter one time on the calculator. Now it wants a right bound, so I'm going to move my cursor to the right, and I'm going to hit enter one time. It wants a guess. A lot of newer calculators don't ask for this. They just give you the answer, but it's older, so I will press enter. And there you see, there is the minimum right there. Y equals negative 0.4058, etc., right? And that's where it occurs, the x value. Let's find the maximum just in case you missed that. So second, trace. Let's go to the maximum. I'll hit enter. And then it says left bounds. So you want to be to the left of your max. So right there, we're to the left of the max at this point. Our x value is to the left of the max. Then you hit enter one time. And then you go to the right. Hit enter one time. But once again, hit enter again. Boom, there it is. You have your x coordinate and your y coordinate where the maximum occurs. So you can get your maximums, you can get your minimums, you can get your inflection point. What if you didn't know if this was 0, 0? Like what if you weren't sure? You know, like in this case, it does cross through 0, 0. It's pretty obvious, but what if you didn't know? See, it's right there, 0, 0. You could actually find it using, in this particular calculator, and many have this, it's called the zero function. So you go back to second trace and you go to 0. And so you want to be to the left of your 0. So that's good enough. We're to the left of our 0 where it crosses the x-axis. So then you hit enter. Then you go to the right. That's good enough, right? We're to the right of it. So you hit enter. You got to help it out because it's older. Hit enter. There we go. We got the zero. What about asymptotes? Well, it doesn't appear that we have any vertical asymptotes, and obviously we can do some mathematics by hand too. So, you know, we're not completely dependent on the calculator, but it's not really clear whether there's any in the picture. You don't see any. So what you can do is you can go to window and you can just make your X min and X max really big. Let's make X min negative 20. How about negative 20? 30 is kind of big. And X max 20. And let's just expand it out just to see what's going on with any asymptotes. And you can see it doesn't look like there's any vertical ones, but look, there's certainly a horizontal one at y equals zero. So boom, you've got the horizontal asymptote. So a calculator is an extremely powerful tool, extremely powerful when you know how to use it. I think it's great. I think it's a great tool, but at the same time, you definitely want to be able to do stuff by hand too, but it does help, right? It does help quite a bit. Let's go back to our other window, which was, I believe, negative 10. 10. I believe that's what we had. Let's check. Yeah, that looks a lot better, right? I think so. So yeah, pretty cool. So hopefully now you get an idea of how to, you know, analyze the graph using a graphing calculator. It's a very powerful tool. And let me just go over it one more time because I know this is one of those things that it's just, let me just go over it. So for example, if I wanted to find the min, I would go to second trace. I would go to minimum. And then left bounds. So I want to be to the left of my minimum. So here's the minimum right here. I'm going to hit enter one time. And then right bounds, you go to the right of the minimum. Hit enter one time. Then hit enter again, and there it is. And most calculators, most models of calculators have these features. They have minimums and maximums. Graphing calculators, right? This is a graphing calculator. So most of them have these same commands and stuff like that. So hopefully this video has been helpful to you. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck and take care.